Hey there, YouTube. I want to show you how to use ChatGPT online, and it's really easy to do. So if you've been putting it off for a while, there's no reason to. Just watch this video a couple minutes or maybe even seconds, and you'll get this installed right now. First of all, if you didn't know, you can get access to Bing Chat right now, which utilizes GPT-4 and will also work with Bing to do online searches. So it'll be effectively similar to this process. Or you can use Google Bard by jumping onto their beta. I'll put those links in the video description, but I signed up for Google Bard like last week. I still haven't got a word back. However, both of those solutions don't provide as good results as ChatGPT with web functionality. I'll currently be focusing on GPT 3.5 since that's what's free right now. You can do the same thing with GPT 4 with better results, but you'll have to pay $20 a month for the premium version. So if you don't have that, this is your video. Now, I'm assuming that you already have ChatGPT, and if you don't, go ahead and go to my video description again and click on the OpenAI link, and you'll be able to sign up for ChatGPT using your Google account or whatever way you want to. As a side note, if you never tried ChatGPT before, you don't want to get logged in, you can actually go to chat-gpt.org and you can actually try it here without logging in. There's even an image generator, so you could just click on try ChatGPT and then I believe you can ask it about 10 questions and you can try it out. If you didn't know, ChatGPT is based on parameters from 2021, so it doesn't connect to the internet. At least not right now. So if you ask it something about 2023, it's gonna say, I can't predict the future, and 2023 hasn't happened yet. So this is why we need the web capability, which is important because a lot has happened since 2021, in particular, something that turned the world upside down. And there's still a lot of things going on right now. So this will give ChatGPT the ability to look those things up. With that being said, let's hook up ChatGPT to the internet, shall we? This is actually super easy. All you have to do is go to my video description and there you'll find a web ChatGPT URL. Go ahead and copy that and then paste it into your Chrome browser. This extension is for Chrome. When you're in there, you'll see web ChatGPT, ChatGPT with internet access. Just go ahead and click on add to Chrome and then add extension. That's it. So this is more of a PSA rather than an installation tutorial because it's so easy to do, but look at that, you're already done. Once you add the Chrome extension, all you gotta do is log into ChatGPT. And once you're in, you'll see at the bottom that you have a button now for web access. So you could turn this off and on if you don't wanna use it. So let's ask it a simple question to test it first. So I'm gonna ask it, who won the 2023 Super Bowl? As you can see, immediately it shows you some web results and it gives you a link that you can go to. So I'm gonna copy this link, test it out while it's thinking, but let me type that in here. So this article is pretty current, but it's not really giving me the answer right away. Can you go through the article? Oh, there it is. Kansas City have been nominated. This is one of the reasons you would need ChatGPT. If you're trying to find a simple question and it's just ads and junk other than the question that you asked. To be fair, it's a free service to us that they're offering. And also you don't have to click on any of the ads, but at the same time, they really try to hide it so you can stay on the site longer and look through all the different ads on the site. And there's a lot. On another note, I mean, I wonder how these sites are going to function because ChatGPT is just getting the info now. We don't have to see all these sites. I mean, really, I just got my answer right here. Kansas City Chiefs. I didn't have to read any of that, and it even showed me the score. Pretty amazing. So if we're not fumbling through their site, being shown all these ads, I wonder how they're gonna make money. That's all I had for this video. It's short and simple, and it's a PSA to let you know it's easier than you think to get web access to your ChatGPT. My next video is gonna be on Bing Chat and comparing that to Google Bard, as well as how to get access to both of those, which it's also pretty simple. You just go to their site. I'm gonna show you how that works, and then I'm gonna ask Bing Chat and also Google Bard a few questions and compare the answers. Thanks for watching and have an awesome day.